our gathering song.
Good morning. Welcome to Chalice Unitarian Universalist Congregation. We are a community of diverse beliefs and experiences, nurturing the liberal religious spirit and united by our desire to grow in love and in service. We celebrate the lives of all people and their ways of expressing care for one another. Whether it's your first time with us in worship or your 100th time, we are glad that you're here. I'm June Bailey, the worship associate today. Our service is led by our minister, Reverend Sharon Wylie. Our worship musician this morning is Tim McKnight. Our song leader is Laura Brown. Our tech team is Hope Campbell and Sarah Komnick. And our greeters are Team Susan, Susan Spoto and Susan Llewellyn. Welcome to our Sunday worship service. Welcome to those of you here in the chapel, and welcome to those of you joining us via Zoom. We welcome children in our community and here in our worship. Please talk with our Director of Family Ministries, Kathleen Swift, to learn more about programs for children. Childcare for our youngest children is always available during services. Today is our monthly all-church worship service, when we worship together in ritual and story, moving our bodies and celebrating the joys of our diverse community. Imbolc is the Neo-Pagan celebration of the earliest signs of spring, an observance that lives on in our modern Groundhog Day. At this morning's service, we honor the goddess Brigid and celebrate the many gifts she offers to those who worship her. For those of us here in the chapel, you will notice that we have the windows open. This is to ensure good air circulation in the room. There are also four air purifiers in the room. Please feel free to leave the chapel if you are uncomfortable for any reason. You will be able to hear what's going on inside when you're out on the courtyard. We're always delighted to see newcomers joining us in worship. As a newcomer, you might be interested in the groups and activities we offer. A good way to get this information is through our email newsletter and e-news calendar. Online, newcomers will receive an email invitation to join our email list after the service. In-person newcomers, if you haven't already given us your email address when you signed in, please share it before you leave. Our weekly email is the best way to get information about the many groups and activities here at Chalice. Now, let's take a breath together.
I'm Judy Cavallo.
I'm Steve Schlesinger.
And we live on land stolen from the Piamquishan, now known as San Marcos.
My name is Dennis Brown, and I live on land stolen from the Piamquishan, now known as Marietta.
My name is Dre Marsh, and I live on land stolen from the Kumeyaay and Piamquishan, now known as Escondido.
My name is Jeff Harlig. I live on land stolen from the Piamquishan. That area is now known as Vista.
I'm Debbie Street Idell. I live on land stolen from the Kumeyaay. It's now known as Scripps Ranch.
My name is Amaki Ayipa, and I live on land stolen from the Piamquishan, now known as San Marcos.
We begin our service by lighting our chalice, the symbol of our Unitarian Universalist faith. The flaming chalice was first used during World War II by the Unitarian Service Committee as a symbol of life-saving refuge for people fleeing persecution in Europe. In honor of our multi-generational community, we invite everyone here with a birthday this month to come forward as you are willing or able so that we may sing a happy birthday song to you. We know we have a handful of congregants with a birthday this month. And how many of you are here? Come on up. January. Sorry, but the month of January. Have we got any January birthdays? Oh.
So we're going to sing for our congregants.
Maybe there's some folks online that are having a birthday. Birthday this month?
Yes.
Jessie Striplin had her baby this week. Baby Emerson, I heard, and is Emerson a boy? A girl named Emerson. So let's sing to baby Emerson. Universalists, people of open minds, loving hearts, and helping hands. Thank you.
Our call to worship is a very beloved piece from Neo-Pagan tradition, The Charge of the Goddess, written by Doreen Valiente and adapted by Starhawk. I who am the beauty of the green earth and the white moon among the stars and the mysteries of the waters, I call upon your soul to arise and come unto me. For I am the soul of nature that gives life to the universe. From me all things proceed, and unto me all things must return. Let my worship be in the heart that rejoices, for behold, all acts of love and pleasure are my rituals. Let there be beauty and strength, power and compassion, honor and humility, mirth and reverence within you. And you who seek to know me, know that the seeking and yearning will avail you not, unless you know the mystery. For if that which you seek you find not within yourself, you will never find it without. For behold, I have been with you from the beginning, and I am that which is attained at the end of desire. Let us worship together. Seated or standing, you are invited to join in singing.
Of the month for January is number 350 in the Gray Hymnal, The Ceaseless Flow of Endless Time. We've been singing this song, this hymn, every Sunday this month to help us get to know the hymn and feel more comfortable singing it.
Our Sunday worship is the shared spiritual practice of our community, and we tend to the congregation during this time by honoring our joys and sorrows. We begin by marking a loss. Alice Dodd, one of our members, passed away this week unexpectedly. In recognition of her physical death, we extinguish the flaming chalice that marks our gathering. We now light a candle of remembrance in recognition that Alice's influence on our community endures. Finally, we relight our flaming chalice in recognition that through our memories of Alice and through the blessings of her many contributions here, our congregation is strengthened and renewed. The light of our community shines ever on. In mystery we are born, in mystery we live, in mystery we die. Whenever we gather together, there will be those among us who are joyful with happy news, as well as those who are grieving or in distress, and those of us feeling all of those things at once. Our challenge at any gathering is how to honor joy and sorrow together. At this time, we invite anyone with a joy or sorrow here in the chapel to come forward and light a candle at our altar. Parents, please assist your children who would like to light a candle. Our congregants online are invited to share joys and sorrows with each other in the chat box, and also to light your own candle of joy and sorrow at home. I will lead us in singing. I've got tears like the raindrops. I've got tears like the raindrops. I've got tears like the raindrops in my soul. I've got tears like the raindrops. I've got tears like the raindrops. I've got tears like the raindrops in my soul. I've got strength like a mountain. I've got strength like a mountain. I've got strength like a mountain in my soul. I've got strength like a mountain. I've got strength like a mountain. I've got strength like a mountain in my soul. Tears like the raindrops. I've got tears like the raindrops. I've got tears like the raindrops. I've got tears like the raindrops in my soul. I've got tears like the raindrops. I've got tears like the raindrops. I've got tears like the raindrops in my soul.
Today is our annual worship service honoring the Neo-Pagan and Celtic holiday of Imbolc, traditionally celebrated on February 1st, at the midpoint between winter solstice and spring equinox. This is a celebration of the earliest signs of spring, when little bits of green might start to show through the snow. We don't have these things. The word Imbolc comes from a Gaelic word for milking, referring to the ewe's milk that indicates the coming birth of the lambs. In a time of long, hard winter, it is important to celebrate even the smallest signs that winter will indeed come to an end. This holiday is strongly associated with the goddess Brigid, also pronounced Breed and Bride. The goddess Brigid, the greatest of the Celtic divinities, is the goddess of poetry, healing, everything high and elevated, such as wisdom, excellence, perfection, high intelligence. And she is also associated with the warmth of the fireside at home. She is also worshipped in the Catholic Christian tradition as Saint Brigid, whose feast day is February 1st. Saint Brigid is one of Ireland's patron saints. So now we'll hear some of the legends about her put together. Many of you will remember Reverend Elizabeth Buchey. And I don't know that we have children in the room, but anyone who would like to sit on the floor is welcome to come up. The Legends of Brigid, compiled by the Reverend Elizabeth Buchey. Once upon a time, there was a holy and powerful woman named Brigid. Maybe she was a woman, maybe a saint, maybe she was a goddess. The mists of time and legend mean there are many different stories about her and who she was and is. She lives in between. They say she was born in the doorway of a barn at dawn on February 1st. So she was born in between, indoors and outdoors, winter and spring, night and day. They say that when she was born, a light like a flame appeared out of her head and stretched all the way to the sky. They say that she loves milk and butter, When she was a baby and couldn't eat, a white cow with red ears appeared to feed her with milk. And that when she was a girl, she gave away all her mother's supply of butter to the poor. Then, when she prayed, even more butter appeared, enough to replace all that she had given away. They say that she gave away precious things to poor people so they could buy food to feed their families. They say she wanted to start a community dedicated to praying and to good work. She came to the king and said, "Give me this land to build the community." It was a good place on a hill, near a lake for water, near a forest with wood for fires to keep warm. A good place to grow food, a place with blueberries to eat and make into jam. The king said, "No, this is my land." So she and her sisters prayed for the king to change his mind. She asked again and said, "Give me as much land as my cloak will cover." Now, can you do much with the amount of land one person's coat can cover up? No, you can't. So the king laughed at her and said, "Certainly, I will grant you this." But Brigid's four sisters took her cloak and stretched it out. One of them walked east, one of them walked south, one of them walked west, one of them walked north. And the cloak grew and grew and spread and covered the whole land, everywhere they could see, the whole place she wanted to build her community. And the king realized she was holy and blessed and gave her not just the land, but other gifts. And so they say that we gather under Bridget's cloak or mantle of healing and wonder. They say that Bridget's place had a holy flame that had burned from the beginning of time, and that Brigid would bless candles and hearths and forges. That if she didn't have anywhere to hang her cloak, she would hang it on a sunbeam. They say that Bridget's place had a holy well, and washing in the water or drinking it would heal you. They say she brought life. If she leaned on something wooden, the dead wood would begin to sprout. They say that she could turn water into beer, and that cows who ran dry would give lots of milk if she touched them, so that no one was ever hungry. They say that this is Brigid's time of year. Now, halfway in between the winter solstice and the spring equinox, that now is a time to bless the candles and celebrate with milk and butter and blueberry jam, to tend the flame, to drink healing waters, to give food to people who need it, to remember that even though the trees look dry and dead, they will sprout again. To know that even though snow covers the ground like a cloak, the seeds are stirring and are alive, waiting for the spring.
So these details about Brigid come from the Folk Story website and the psychologist Jonathan Young. Brigid is the greatest of the Celtic divinities and is closely associated with the land. She is the protector of the wells and springs, the guardian of nature, and therefore agriculture. She is specifically associated with livestock. And as a fertility goddess, Brigid is also the patron of the poets, artists, and others who create. Her name is invoked at childbirth. When Brigid slipped into the world, a tower of flame rose from the top of her head to the heavens. Her fire aspect means she is the goddess of the hearth and the forge.
She is the guardian of those who work with metal. And by extension, she is the goddess of the machine. If we have difficulties with our cars or computers, I should say when we have difficulties with our cars or computers, our pleas for divine intercession might be properly addressed to Brigid. The plume of fire radiating from her head connects her to the life of the mind. She's the patron of scholars and colleges. One implication is that learning is a form of service to the divinities. She's also the protector of travelers. This applies to both those who explore new terrains and those seekers who are on inner journeys. Brigid is said to have invented the fervent Irish morning wail called keening. Part of her presence resides in the fairy spirit, whose keening can be heard at night in times of grief. Down through the years, mythic stories continue to enchant. On close inspection, the images have much to say about modern life. Joseph Campbell said, "The ability to see the metaphors in the old tales opens us to the richness of everything around us. The whole world turns into a holy picture. We can become aware of a dimension of significance in the ordinary that is nothing short of radiant." So let us honor the Great Mother, the Queen of Heaven. May we be open to her many gifts of inspiration in this season of renewal. In a moment, you will be invited to come forward to receive Brigid's blessings. You will reach your hand into Brigid's well to take what she offers. It is not your place to look for what you think you want, but to receive that which your hand touches first, and to know it is the gift meant for you this day. We also have a bowl with gifts of beauty for our younger congregants, but I don't think we have a younger people in here right now. Our online congregants will hopefully receive a link to follow to receive Brigid's gift of poetry. And if that doesn't come up during the service, or if you don't want to click on something during the service, you'll also receive that link in an email afterwards. So take a breath with me. We're going to sing together while we do this, because of course we are. I invite the willing to come forward to receive your blessings, and I invite you to join me in singing. And again, June has gifts for the littles if you, if there's someone in here I can't see, but also if you want to take something with you for a little one.
Holy water, sacred flame, Brigid, we invoke your name. Bless our hands, our heads, our hearts, source of healing, song, and art. Holy water, sacred flame, Brigid, we invoke your name. Bless our hands, our heads, our hearts, source of healing, song, and art. Holy water, sacred flame, Brigid, we invoke your name. Bless our hands, our heads, our hearts, source of healing, song, and art. Twice more. Holy water, sacred flame, Brigid, we invoke your name. Bless our hands, our heads, our hearts, source of healing, song, and art. Once more. Holy water, sacred flame, Brigid, we invoke your name. Bless our hands, our heads, our hearts, source of healing, song, and art. We all come from the goddess, and to her we shall return like a drop of rain flowing to the ocean. We all come from the goddess, and to her we shall return like a drop of rain flowing to the ocean. We all come from the goddess, and to her we shall return like a drop of rain, sorry, flowing to the ocean. We all come from the goddess, and to her we shall return like a drop of rain flowing to the ocean. We all come from the goddess, and to her we shall return like a drop of rain flowing to the ocean. Last time. We all come from the goddess, and to her we shall return like a drop of rain flowing to the ocean.
The Sunday offering is an expression of the generosity that makes our congregational life possible. As Buddhist teacher Joseph Goldstein has said, it is important to understand that generosity is a practice, not just a single event. It's a quality in our hearts and minds that we can develop and cultivate. Please text your donation to Chalice. If you haven't texted a donation before, know that once you text the amount, you'll get a reply with a link to follow to enter your credit card information. If you have already entered this information previously when you've donated, you won't need to enter it again. If your Sunday donation is meant to be a part of your pledge payment, please be sure to indicate pledge after the dollar amount. The phone number for text donations will be on screen in a moment. If you prefer to make an in-person donation of cash or check, there are envelopes and a donation box to the left of the chapel double doors. You can leave those donations after the service. Please give generously. Please join in dedicating our offering with words of affirmation.
We give to the work of Chalice Congregation. Our work weaves the fab of love called community. To this end, we dedicate ourselves and this our offering.
Our story is called You Are Never Alone, written by Ellen Kelsey and illustrated by Soyeon Kim. Every moment, this beautiful planet showers you with gifts. Clouds rain fresh water to quench your thirst. Your lungs swell with oxygen that plants create. Earthworms, ground beetles, and ants plow the soil where your vegetables grow. Nature touches every bite you eat. You gobble fruits from plants pollinated by bats in the twilight and bees in the day. Ocean algae thicken the ice cream you lick. You devour fish who ate tiny plankton fertilized by poop from whales in the sea. When danger lurks, help comes in wild ways. Mangrove roots hold tight to slippery mudslides. Poplar trees drink up floods. Forests of undersea kelp calm ferocious waves. You are protected by a generous world of green. Branches stretch across streets, creating peaceful neighborhoods. Mother trees entwine their roots, raising vast shady forests that keep you and the planet cool. You always have company. Armies of microorganisms snuggle against your skin, keeping germs at bay. Your face is a home to wee little cleaning mites who evolved from mites that lived on the faces of your relatives. You grow strong with the help of bacteria that digest the food in your tummy. They were passed down from your mother when you were born. If things break, remember healing happens too. Corals rebuild strong reefs just as your bones mend a fracture. Aloe vera soothes your itchy skin. Ginger settles your upset tummy. Wallowing in the mud makes you smarter, thanks to a surge of feel-good chemicals triggered by bacteria in the soil. You thrive through connections to the land and the sea. Whales rise and dive, splashing phytoplankton to the surface where the sun powers their growth. Krill gobble these ocean plants and become food for salmon. Bears drag spawn salmon onto shore, spreading fishy nutrients that help massive trees grow. Forests maintain the Earth's climate. More whales mean more plants and fish and bears and a healthier you. You turn to pets for support, just as they count on you. Gaze into your dog's eyes and you both feel a rush of love. Just thinking about your cat soothes lonely times. You sense these wild connections. Sunshine fills you with hope. Your imagination smiles when you climb a tree. You are never alone. Feel gravity hug you tight as you twirl around the sun.
Beloved goddess, we thank you for your gifts of compassion, poetry, beauty, healing, and metalwork. I ask that you watch over this congregation in the coming year, bless us and keep us, that we in turn may bless the world with your love. So mote it be. You're invited once again to rise in body or spirit to join in singing.
Our sending words are adapted from a traditional blessing attributed to Saint Brigid. May Brigid bless this gathering, this house of love. Bless every window, every wall and door. Bless every heart that beats beneath its roof. Bless every hand that toils to bring it joy. Bless every foot that walks its portals through. May Brigid bless this house that shelters you. May it be so. Amen and blessed be. Love and blessings to each of you. You are invited to close our time by singing the well, and after our hymn, please return to your seats for an announcement.
Hi, this is an invitation to help develop long-range goals and update our vision statement by attending a discussion salon. Every 5 years or so, the Board of Trustees develops long-range goals for the congregation, and an important component of this work is a review of our vision statement. You are invited to make an important contribution to this work by attending a discussion salon where we are asking you to consider these questions. Who shall we invite to join us, and how do we mean to change their lives? And what programs would you like that Chalice does not currently have, and how would you improve the programs we already have? We will have 4 sessions starting next Sunday between services and the last Sunday in February after the second service. And then we'll have 2 Zoom sessions on Friday, one Friday morning, February 9th, and one Friday evening, February 16th. So you'll be getting a single subject email about all this, explaining it in more detail this coming week, and the links to the Zoom meetings and stuff will be in the e-news announcements. Okay, thank you very much from the Board of Trustees.
Our social hour will begin in a few minutes online at this same Zoom link and in person on our courtyard. Those of you here in person may want to bring your refreshments into the, I believe it's the blue room, and have a visit with our online congregants. And Reverend Sharon and I look forward to greeting you at the doors to hear how the service was for you. Go in peace.